Hello everyone, welcome to a video lecture on basics of cellular system. Myself K.R. Biradar, assistant professor, department of electronics and telecommunication engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this video, you will be able to illustrate the basics of cellular system. Before going further, you will come to know what is cellular system. In cellular system, the service area is divided into cells. The transmitter is designed to serve an individual cell. Here transmitter refers to the base station of cellular system. The system seeks or finds to make efficient use of available channels by using low power transmitters to allow frequency reuse concept at a much smaller distances. What is the frequency reuse? It is a technique for which using a specified range of frequencies more than once in the same radio system so that the total capacity of the system is increased. With this, what happens? The capacity of the overall system increases. Here, cell refers to a geographical area. Generally, it is considered to be a hexagonal shaped cell. Move on to next slide. Cellular telephone systems. Cellular telephone system provides connection to the public switched telephone network for any user location within the radio range of the system with the following motto or characteristics. It has to provide large number of users within the available spectrum. It also provides large geographical coverage area. It gives the service with only limited frequency spectrum. Another important feature of cellular telephone system is that reuse of the radio frequency by the concept of cell in a given geographical area. Here, large geographical area is divided into smaller cells and allocated frequency channels are reused again in another cells by making the reuse distance into consideration. Basic cellular systems. A basic cellular system consists of three main parts. Those are a mobile unit, a base station, and a mobile switching center. A cellular telephone system provides wireless connection to the PSTN, that is public switched telephone network, for any user location within the radio range of the system. Cellular systems accommodate a large number of users over a large geographical area within a limited frequency spectrum. Cellular radio systems provide high quality service. High capacity is achieved by limiting the coverage of each base station transmitter to a small geographical area called a cell, so that the same radio channels may be reused by another base station located some distance away. A sophisticated switching technique called a handoff is used that enables a call to proceed uninterrupted when the user moves from one cell to another cell. Figure shows a basic cellular system which consists of mobile stations, base stations, and a mobile switching center. The mobile switching center is also called a mobile telephone switching office. Since It is responsible for connecting all mobiles to the PSTN in a cellular system. Each mobile communicates via radio with one of the base station and may be handed off to any number of base stations throughout the duration of the call. The mobile station contains a transceiver. What the transceiver is? It is a combination of transmitter and receiver. An antenna and control circuitry may be mounted in a single vehicle as a portable handle unit. The base station consists of several transmitters and receivers, which simultaneously handle full duplex communications and generally have towers which support several transmitters and receiving antennas. The base station serves as a bridge between all mobile users in the cell and connects the simultaneous mobile calls via telephone lines or microwave links to the MSC. The MSC coordinates the activities of all of the base stations and it connects the entire cellular system to the PSTN. Communication between the base station and the mobiles is defined by a standard common air interface that specifies four different channels. The channels used for voice transmission from the base station to mobiles are called forward channels. And the channels used for voice transmission from mobile to the base station are called reverse channels. The two channels responsible for initiating mobile calls are called forward control channels and reverse control channels. Control channels are often called setup channels because they are only involved in setting up a call and moving it to an unused voice call. Control channels transmit and receive data messages that carry call initiation and service requests and are monitored by mobiles when they do not have a call in progress. Cordless telephone system. See the figure. Cordless telephone systems are full duplex communication systems that use radio to connect a portable handset to a dedicated base station, which is then connected to a dedicated telephone line with a specific telephone number on the public switched telephone network. In first generation cordless telephone systems, the portable unit communicates only to the dedicated base unit and only over distance of few tens of meters. Second generation cordless telephones have recently been introduced, which allow subscribers to use their handset at many outdoor locations. Modern cordless telephones are sometimes combined with phaging receivers so that a subscriber may first be phased and then respond to the phase using the cordless telephone. Cordless telephone systems provide the user with limited range and mobility, as it is usually not possible to maintain a call if the user travels outside the range of the base station. Typically, second generation base stations provide coverage range up to few hundred meters. Phaging systems. Phaging systems are communication systems that send brief messages to a subscriber. Depending on the type of service, the messages may be either a numeric message, an alphanumeric message, or a voice message. Phaging systems are typically used to notify a subscriber of the need to call a particular telephone number or to travel to a known location to receive further instructions. In modern paging systems, news headlines, stock quotations, and faxes may be sent. A message is sent to paging subscriber via the paging system access number with a telephone keypad or modem. The issued message is called a phase. The paging system then transmits the phase throughout the service area. Using base stations which broadcast the phase on a radio carrier. Phaging systems vary widely in their complexity and coverage area. While simple phaging systems may cover a limited range of 2 km to 5 km, wide area phaging system consists of a network of telephone lines, many base station transmitters, and a large radio towers that simultaneously broadcast a phase from each base station. This is called simulcasting. In this slide, we shall see a small MCQ question. Which of the following is or are the main parts of the basic cellular system? Can you guess the answer? So the options are given. First one is a mobile unit, second one is a cell site, third one is a mobile telephone switching office, last fourth one is all of the above. Pause the video and try to think and guess your answer. I think you might have got the answer in your mind. The correct answer for this question is D, all of the above, because all the three parts of the cellular system. These are the references used to prepare the above PPT. Thank you.